which from the start and contains scenes you may find upsetting.
Jamaican men just like to have their young girls and them having them breed up. Not this one. Mm-mm.
If you've got a doll, baby doll, after a while it gets ruined, the hair gets made on it and everything, so you have to throw it away. But with a real baby, you've got to keep it. And you look after it and change its nappies and things like that, and it's yours.
It's just the facts of life. There's no master plan.
Other countries have managed to bring their rates of teenage pregnancy down dramatically. Our rates here in Britain are the highest in Western Europe.
We've launched a national campaign to bring down the rate of teenage pregnancies across the country.
And that's why we've launched a national campaign to bring the rates of teenage pregnancy down.
And to bring those rates of pregnancy down.
Perfect.
Great.
Have you got any pain?
Okay, in your stomach, I mean.
Go on.
That's a good girl. Keep going.
The government wants to halve the number of teenage pregnancies over the next 10 years. 90,000 teenagers get pregnant every year in the UK. About half of these choose to have an abortion. This is the story of two young women who've made very different decisions.
I found out I was pregnant when I went to get the pill, and that's when they said I couldn't have the pill because I was pregnant already.
Okay, all right. And this is your first pregnancy?
Yeah, and my last.
About a pound for everyone who says that.
Marie is 14 years old and 5 months pregnant. She's visiting Brooke, the Young People's Sex Advice Charity.
How old were you when you first had sex?
Yeah, about 11.
Okay. And that was consenting? You were quite happy to have sex at that age?
They don't know the words for the parts of their bodies they're talking about. They don't know the words for the act. Often they're doing things that they don't know how to describe. They don't know what it is. You know, we have clients who come in here and they're not sure if they're having sex or not. And I find that disturbing, to be honest.
They're strangers in their own body.
I couldn't bother to tidy my room.
Marie had regular sex, but rarely used condoms.
I don't know many kids my age that have, like, pregnant and stuff. I always thought when you get to the age of 15, 16, that's the sort of time you start worrying about it. But not 14. I always thought 14-year-olds couldn't get pregnant.
Marie's boyfriend, Joe, is in foster care 30 miles away in Southend. He's just turned 15.
Do you know when you're with someone and you want to be with them all the time? That's how it is, because I really do care about him. But he's an arsehole, basically. You just care about the wrong sort of person. And that's what I did. If I had my way, I'd be 14, going to school, get my education, and not going out of nowhere, basically. Just sorting out my education life, basically. Not being pregnant, I wouldn't be pregnant.
You did have your way, I mean, you chose to keep it.
Yeah, but mainly I chose to keep it because I couldn't go through with having an abortion. It's like killing another person.
I see a lot of young women who have babies because it's something to do. Sometimes pregnancy happens to people and they just let it go because it seems like almost more frightening to make a decision than it is to just let it happen.
They told me I was pregnant, so...
Okay, so you need a referral.
Yeah. Okay, brilliant.
Zihanna is 18 and 10 weeks pregnant. Up till now, she plans to keep the baby, but she doesn't trust her boyfriend and has changed her mind. It's an especially hard decision, as she's a practicing Catholic.
With church, abortion is like the most terrible thing you could do, because I was brought up in a Catholic family and I went to a Catholic school, and I was always told that abortion isn't right, and once you've done it, you should have it.
Okay, what have you
plan is that you want to do?
Termination of the cycle.
And do you feel sure about your decision?
Yeah, the only thing that makes me feel guilty is because my boyfriend wants it. And
right.
I don't think I'm ready. I know I'm not ready yet.
I don't want to be still living in Brixton, still having my child, you know what I mean? Giving the council flat or anything like that. I don't want to be doing that. I just feel like I've got more to life. I don't know what it is, I just feel like I've got more.
You've always been ambitious.
I mean, I've always been determined about, I don't know, making it in either music business or drama.
Zaihana's boyfriend is 27 and lives in Birmingham. Her parents are Jamaican. Her father left the family 3 years ago.
But she felt so bad when dad left. She's thinking, how's her child gonna feel? And it would hardly see the father. As if he saw it at all.
Plus, when dad left, it's like, that's when I just started getting boyfriends after boyfriends after boyfriends. It's like I was looking for that.
Yeah, that love that you lost.
Yeah. Someone to take care of me. But I was sensible then times because I used protection.
But you used it this time and it split.
Yeah, I did. That's if it did, that's what he said.
But that you put on the condom?
No.
You're joking, I would never trust a guy to put on a condom.
I don't, believe me, I never trust none of them anymore.
Look at them little wares on the chin.
You can't be
the
man then, Mark.
Yeah? Well, I've always been a man.
Marie lives in one of London's poorest boroughs. She and her friends regularly miss school. This is what the government terms social exclusion, and girls from these backgrounds are 10 times more likely to get pregnant than those from wealthier areas.
How many girlfriends have you had? I don't know.
He can't actually call them girlfriends because he doesn't have a relationship with them for more than one day. For about half an hour, innit, Mark? That's
where's
the top,
Rochelle,
isn't it? How old is you, Lou?
Oh, you ain't had it, have you, Lou?
You guys go over any girl that wants, that'll give you anything.
The children aren't popular with the neighbours.
These kids, I tell you what, they terrorise this place. We've had enough of it. They graffiti our walls. They kick our cars, chuck footballs at our cars. The lot.
We're kids, yeah. If there was something for us to do, yeah, we'd do it. But there's nothing for us to do. So all we're doing is hanging on the streets here. There's no parks around here, there's nothing. Wherever we go, we get in trouble for doing anything.
Move then!
Move! This ain't nothing to do with you. This ain't your house. Wait till us to
I live here, and you live there. Go stand over there, then.
Don't talk to me like that. I'll come and box you in your face.
Gannon. I will.
As soon as you lay a finger on me, I swear I'd get you banged up so fast you know what hit you. Yeah, do you want a bit?
Marie lives at home with her mum and 3 brothers and sisters.
Don't talk to me like that.
Marie's talking to me like that. Is it same thing?
Just stop it now.
Get out now. Go to your room and shut it. Move.
No.
Move.
No.
Do it yourself, Ben.
I thought I asked you to pull it out, not put the clip in it.
Another one in a good mood.
Altogether, Judy's had 7 children. She was also a teenage mother and was a grandmother in her 30s.
I must have done something wrong, or my oldest girl fell pregnant when she was 16, so couldn't have done that much good. How was that going? After that, they didn't listen one or another. No, my lord, it's probably didn't listen.
About your kids having their partners stay in the house?
No, I'm old-fashioned. I'm afraid. It's my house. While they live in here, they don't do that.
First thing to think was seriously annoyed. Seriously annoyed. I wanted to batter her, and once I realised it was Joe, batter him. But they're no longer that little girl that looks up to their father. It's a case of they've got their blokes now. They'll go to their bloke and they expect him to do a lot of sorting out for them and helping them through things rather than turn into your, to the dead.
How does that make you feel?
Gutted. Feel like I lost her. Too young. You know? So like I say, I always called her Miss Sexy, and for a little while after finding out, I found it hard to say that to her. Because it all changed.
In a way, I've always wanted my dad to hit him. But I don't want my dad to hit him because I know as soon as my dad touches it, my dad's going to go down for it. Because Joey's underage and my dad is a man.
So protecting your dad?
Yeah, more than protecting Joe. Because I love my dad to bits. I wouldn't let my dad go to prison for no one. My dad was a bit like Joe when my dad was a teenager. But my dad was a little bit worse than Joe, basically. No, I want someone that gets a little bit in trouble. Like, someone that's gonna, has got a criminal record, but it's not as bad as everybody else's, if you get me. Like, it's not like, he goes and robs cars and things like that, that's nothing really, you know what I mean? Not if it's like, I wouldn't go for someone if it was for like, GBH or something like that.
Come on, Jade. Hold up, mate.
Marie's parents are separated, but Jim still spends his weekends in the family home. Tonight, Marie's had some bad news, and the family need to talk.
I hate him at the moment.
Yeah, it's not going too well for you with him, is it?
No. No, he doesn't want to see me anymore. He's staying in Southend. He doesn't want to come back to London.
At the moment?
At the moment. But he said he still wants to have something to do with his kid, though. At least that's something.
Yeah, it's surprising, wasn't it? What you think is love. You know what I mean? It's your first real boyfriend as well, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's a bit of relief, isn't it, really?
You know what I'm thinking, don't you? Yeah. Right?
What are you thinking?
I want a battery. Do you know what I mean? He gets my daughter pregnant and he wants to fuck off and not take the responsibility. No. He was born before. He shouldn't even be messing about with her. And now it's a case of, what, love him and leave him, pregnant? No, it don't fucking work. Shouldn't happen. Should not happen at all. There's too many people doing the same sort of thing as well. But, you know, I mean, 14 and left her in this position. Or wants to leave her in this position at the moment, you know? It's fucking wrong. I don't want to see him. If I see him, I'll, do you know what I mean? He'd be going up the hospital.
But she's all right, you.
Come on, Bobby. He'll be all right. I know it's not the right time to say, like, I told you something, but...
I did feel used by Joe. Because... I thought he felt the same way about me, but obviously he didn't, because if he felt the same way, he would at least try it, you know what I mean? And it looks to me like he's got what he wanted out of me and now he's gone off again.
What did he want?
He wanted sex, basically, and I gave it to him. And then when the responsibilities come up, he didn't want nothing else, he didn't want nothing to do with him.
Do you regret having sex with him?
Yeah, I do. The boys just use them for whatever they can get, basically.
Do you think girls like sex as much as boys?
I don't know. Most of my friends don't. They only sleep with the boys to keep them happy. Because they think, well, they won't like me if I don't give it to them.
Marie's girlfriends have come round to talk babies and boys.
If the girls don't enjoy it, she's going to go back into their mates. They're going to get shamed to the ground, didn't they? So boys do care if the girl enjoys it or not. And they always try afterwards, yeah, after you step them, they always try to make your mind change. If you say it's crap, yeah, they always try to make your mind change differently.
Willie's getting fed, yeah, it's disgusting.
If you close your eyes and don't look at it, you should be alright. That's how I do it. Just don't look at it.
I'll tell you what is disgusting, blowjobs. I've never seen it in my whole life. Never.
In it. That's rank. They got a toilet out of that thing, you know what I mean? And that's got to go in your mouth. No way. I said if they want it done, they can do it their bloody self.
No, they say it won't come up here.
Yeah, that's their favourite one.
What?
They say they won't come up.
They won't come up.
They'll pull out before they come. But they never end up doing it.
But how do they know when they're going to do it?
Charlene, your body tells you when you're going to come. Boys know Charlene things like that, Char.
Oh, that's disgusting.
Sorry, I just don't feel well. Try to hurry up.
Zaihana had the symptoms of early pregnancy. She must wait 3 more weeks for a termination.
She can't do anything. Just vomiting all the time.
Yeah.
Her mother and her boyfriend both want her to keep the baby.
Once he found out that he's going to have a child, he wasn't happy, but I mean, he wanted the child straight away. He just feels that, you know, you should keep your responsibility once you made it. And, you know, it's like the macho thing to take care of your child, give them money basically. You don't have to be there, just give them money. He said, I'm murdering it, killing it. So, don't think he thinks I'm doing him a favour. Oh, God. I always think about it, like what it will look like, and if it's a boy or a girl, because I'll never know. But I try not to think about it all the time. I just put it on the back of my head.
We know that. Tell us when it ends. Marie, come on. Listen, what are you going to do when this baby wakes up and starts crying his eyes out?
No, I'm getting up.
You are getting up. Now, come on. Don't get me across now. Come on.
Don't get you fucking across. You're the one that's going to go to bloody school for no reason.
You've got to go to school because you've got to learn. Now, come on. Come on, you're going to lose enough of your education later on. Come on, you've only got a few more weeks to go and then you can stop getting up in the morning.
Marie goes to a centre for children who have problems in the mainstream school system. The centre's main aim is to improve students' self-esteem.
I think you're just being modest. That's a very good piece of work. You put it very much in the style and spirit of the picture and you've mixed some wonderful colours.
It would
Don't
be.
You think?
No.
Yeah. It's going very well.
No, everything I do, I think it's horrible. Because it's the fact that I did it. I want to throw it in the bin.
Is there anything you're proud of that could do that?
At the moment.
That's what I was just going to say. Draw that.
But I will be soon.
And that line there, you've got a statue and the cloud.
Because I'm going to be proud when my kid gets, when I have that. My baby.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You draw that green, yeah.
Oh, I hate this number.
It's a week till Zaihana's termination. Her boyfriend's furious about her decision, and she suspects this is why he hasn't called.
He ain't gonna pick up.
Yeah.
How come you're acting like this? And I can't sit around waiting for your phone call anymore. What? And it's like you take me as a big joke, keep laughing. Can you stop laughing? You always say don't worry, but... I wish I couldn't, but I have to, you know? I'm gonna go through this by myself. I mean, it's like I'm losing both of you. It's like I'm losing both of you. Yeah. You're confused in my head. It's either you want to be with me or you don't. Huh? Are you holding a baby? He's holding a baby like he's in on purpose. I was talking to him and then all of a sudden I heard a baby start crying.
and it just got louder and louder and louder. So I knew he put the phone over her mouth, whatever. And he said, the baby's pretty, the beautiful baby's pretty, pretty baby.
That's Jamaican, man. They just like to have baby moms here, there and everywhere so they can go get, have their sex wherever, you know, because they're not going to get it off their baby mom. When I was having a baby, that's when he loves me, you know. We're going to get married and everything. But then afterwards, it just, once he found out I was having the termination, he just, I just knew it was kind of funny. Wish I could just forget about him, but I can never forget about him in my own lifetime now. Because I'm always going to remember this, always.
And then when it's your turn to go into theatre, the nurse will escort you into the theatre. We'll ask you just to lie on the couch.
Zihanna's already had counselling at Brook. Now she's been referred to Mary Stopes for her abortion.
The procedure in itself takes about 2 minutes. And then when you wake up, it'll be about 5 minutes from the time that you're put to sleep. Have you any idea of your gestation at the moment, how far you're into your pregnancy you are?
3 months. When I was having the scan, it's like, you are having the child.
Definitely a pregnancy there.
When she said that, she saw it. It made me feel a bit funny, like, inside. I was going to ask her if I could see it, but I thought, no, it might make me act funny. I feel a bit lonely because I feel like everyone wants the baby, and I'm the only person who, you know, just who thinks that I should be doing this. But, you know, it's just, I just want more in life, basically. And right now I haven't got anything. So I don't know what I could be offering that child.
Marie's last scan detected a problem with her baby's kidneys. She's been called to have further tests.
Does she have the test for Down syndrome? No. When they measure the fluid behind the neck? Down syndrome babies do have kidney problems as well. So we may need to just adjust the risk of baby having Down syndrome from this. It looks more like a structural problem than a genetic problem, but we can't be sure.
Did you have a test for Down syndrome before?
You didn't. Right. That is
possibility.
One of the possibilities.
Oh, okay.
No, they just, she might ask to do it whether they have a test done on that.
Oh.
So you might have to have one done.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, it's yours no matter what it is, isn't it?
Down seems unlikely, but the severity of the kidney problems won't be known until after the birth.
It was so scary, it's unbelievable. It's one of those days you wish you'd never have to go through, but you have to go through. And I wish Joe was there that day. So he'd be there to help me through it even a little bit more.
Shut up!
Got some cereal. You want a cuddle? Come on. Hmm?
6 months into the pregnancy, Marie's finding things increasingly hard, and Joe still hasn't been in touch.
He died? What really get you tired? Hmm? Yeah. Still a bubby, ain't you? Yeah.
She's suffered from depression for the last few years, and Judy's very worried about her.
Such a lot for her to take on, though, for things. Don't know whether she can handle all of it.
Do you worry that you'll be left with it?
No, don't worry, no. Just like having another one of the grandchildren staying, so I still was, you know.
No, it's what will happen, the effect it will have on her that worries me. She's not a stable child.
Yeah.
I'm getting all wet again. It's just trying to cope with being a teenager and being pregnant all in one go, isn't it? That's just a little bit too much, isn't it? Me? It's like trying to cram everything in a small little jar, isn't it? Mm? It won't fit, will it, Bubby? Something's got to give, eh? Mm?
Do you think it's the pregnancy and, you know, everything else she's going through at the moment is the hardest thing she's been through?
No. I think it's the second hardest thing she's been through. Losing her brother the way she did and the guilt that she felt around that time, I think that was probably the hardest thing that she had to deal with.
4 years ago, Marie's half-brother Michael was murdered. He was 15.
The day he got murdered, there was a disagreement between them, and it was something that weren't resolved in a nice way. And for a long time after that, yeah, I mean, even like a year and a half, 2 years, she was still saying, when she got down, that she kept feeling guilty about it. Yeah? Because of the loss of Michael, that was the reason, not what I thought she was keeping herself for. You know, it takes a life, bringing life into the world. And I think maybe that's what I, one of my thoughts at the time, yeah, when she'd made that decision.
With 2 weeks to go till she leaves school, Marie's had to write a story for her English lesson about an important event in her life.
My life changed in a big way. It's called that because when my brother died, everything in my life changed. It weren't normal. So I just changed, put the title out. Because after my brother died, I was threatened by my brother's killer's mates. They said they were going to do to me what they did to my brother. And ever since then, I've always thought that before someone's going to kill me. It's hard when you're scared of everything, all new people that have come around you, you're scared of, because you don't know whether they know the people that killed your brother and whether they're going to do it to you. So you don't really go to school and meet people, you want to just stay at home and have your life at home.
Yeah, what's it, Rolls? A cheese Wopsit with butter and a roll.
I put a little tin on my belly and I was laying down flat, tin on my belly, and I was tapping the baby, calling out his name, Jordan, and doing that, and it would kick and the tin was going up and down. It looked really weird. It's just a natural thing to me now.
School,
my friends don't go to school.
Oh, don't they?
No, they should do, but they can't let bunk school a lot of the time.
Oh, okay. Do you like school though?
No.
No. You're not missing anything at all.
No.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, I'll let you get off to your friends then. You don't miss anything. There you go.
Yeah, miss the police and miss not getting in trouble. That's a good thing to miss.
They're a bit troublemakers.
Yeah, troublemakers are they? The words.
Yeah.
They thieve, nick cars, break people's houses and everything.
How old are these kids?
13, 14.
Like 13 and 14, breaking into cars and houses.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
And the girl, she's 13. She should nick a car, didn't she?
Yeah, she knows how to black box it and drive it as well.
I've obviously got a lot to learn, I'll tell you.
Age of 13 then and all that, you know what I mean?
But you're not up to anything like that, are you?
No.
I would never do that. I ain't got a death wish.
With your mum.
My mum and dad.
So how do you feel about having a baby and maybe not being out to go out with your friends?
In a way, I'm happy about it.
Yeah?
Because they're just getting into too much trouble at the moment.
Yeah.
Oh, it's all the fucking time.
Yeah, they don't go to school. Time. You want to get the truancy officers around you and everything.
Marie's friends have been accused of breaking a car window. The police have been called, and Marie's come out to see what the commotion's about.
I am not. I'm a perfect little angel. Not.
No.
I'm not that bad.
Is it real, girl?
them.
They wish that you'd been.
Normal for teenage things you can't do, because you've got to think of your kid. Because you can't play football as much, you can't run about, you can't go stealing cars and things like that. You can't do drugs, basically. So you've got to be that little bit more mature. And it does make it difficult around your friends because they do see you totally differently. They don't see you the same age as them, basically. They see you as someone else. And that's scary because you don't know whether they still want to be your friend.
Jim spends most of his time at his best mate Mick's house. They're both unemployed.
What about their
futures?
If they don't go to school
and they don't get
exams,
they'll end up like me.
And me? Dimwit.
Not dimwit, no.
What
do
you
mean end up like you?
Social misfit. You don't... There's a thing that I was being told, well, it's the norm. What people expect as a norm. Now, which is 2.4 children when you're an adult and attending school, getting the right qualifications, getting a proper job, earning constant money, supporting yourself, supporting your family and everything else. But normal life is very rarely like that now.
For everything I need for the baby...
2, 4... It's going to be about £500,
£600. It's too much money. Just the money that people ain't got.
Well, let's see what the tree out in the garden gives me. If it gives me enough money, then yeah. No,
my daddy promised me.
I'm not talking about what he promised you.
No, I am. What he's promised me. He promised me he'll have my bedroom done the way I want it.
Right.
When the baby's born.
Dad always breaks his promises.
True.
What I'll do is broccoli to pay Paul.
What?
What it means is for 2 weeks, I won't pay no bills, right? Because that gives me like 50, 60 quid in
there. And it's at the end of the month, and that's when all your catalog bills come through as well.
Look, don't you worry about it. I'll sort it out. Right. Hopefully the social will help me out.
I'm sorry to say this, yeah, Mum, but you've been saying that for the last 3 years. Did I never do anything? No. Grown up in a totally different way to them as well. Where they're just going to grow up as normal kids, basically. I'm going to grow up as a kid come adult.
It's Marie's 15th birthday. She's decided to celebrate at home with her family instead of her friends.
Get your ass upstairs, darling.
Happy birthday to you.
She's stopped going out and has started going to bed early.
Happy birthday to you.
Did it help me plan that, JT?
The day before Zihanna's termination, she's calling her boyfriend to find out once and for all where she stands.
So how's your girlfriend?
What's up?
Oh, come on. You ain't getting no sex off me, so you must be getting it off somebody.
I said, obviously, you've got another woman, but you're not going to tell me.
That's what makes the man go world go round. And they can't do that.
Mum.
It always has to have a woman in his life.
I know, men always have to have a woman, I'm
That's
sorry.
Right.
No, listen to what I have to say. If I change my mind, would you still be acting like that?
Oh,
come on.
You're telling me what your independence. You don't want to
know.
I'm not saying anything bad, but we're just saying the reason why.
You're just saying the reason why.
why she doesn't want to keep it yet is because she wants to have, she wants to be financially independent. She wants to be in her career. She wants to be able to offer her child. Me, Sabrina, her sister. And a sober background.
It's not murdering a child.
God will give it back in another chance.
It's not.
God will give back that life.
You don't know what he's telling you.
It wouldn't work true. Even if she kept it. Oh.
He's saying it would never work, so it's better if you just get on with your life. Because you've made your decision already. So why are you talking about keeping it?
Oh, so in other words, even if she had kept the baby, it wouldn't have worked. Oh, right, now that you know, I think, I understand. And, you know, we put her through a lot of difficulty.
Don't get upset. I'm not.
It was Zai's boyfriend who broke off their relationship, but her mother sided with him because she also thinks Zai should keep the baby.
I mean, that's a man's pride and thing. He's a nice guy, you know? He's a nice guy, but... Oh, God, Zai never listen. And I don't know what's wrong.
It's not my fault!
I know,
it was
not...
blaming me!
Well,
everyone hates me.
No one
you
didn't have to.
Hates me.
Oh, God, do what you have to do. You just listen to people. Then that would never happen. This is how we pay our price. And they're very hard prices.
I just feel like everyone hates me and I just don't.
Nobody hates
I just want to just convince people I'm...
Nobody hates you,
yes,
Zai.
Yes, they do.
Who? Nobody hates you. Stop being silly.
Well, they all think I can handle it, but...
You know, as long as you know why you're doing it, that's all that matters.
I do know why, but I don't want everyone to, like...
Well, that's all that matters, then. Nobody hates you. Stop being silly. Zai.
In a way, I don't want a baby. I don't want this baby. The truth is, I don't want it. Do you know what I mean? Because it's fucking up my life completely, basically. It's my mind, that's what it is. In a way, I'm scared of coping with it because it is going to be my responsibility from now on. It is going to be me that's waking up and like, 12 o'clock in the morning, going to make a bottle and giving it back to the baby, you know what I mean? It's not going to be my mum doing it. And where I was younger, when my little brother and my little sister were born, my mum did all that. And I used to just sit there and watch her. It's going to be me that's doing it now. So it scares me. But I think I could cope with it. I'm hoping I do anyway. I'll give it my best shot as well. Please, please be a good little boy. I'm begging you. I do love you. And I'm sorry for shouting at you. I'm sorry for most probably hitting you or grinding you or something, but I'm really sorry for it. More than anything, just try and be good for me. And be happy.
Marie went into labour 3 weeks early, insisting she watch the end of EastEnders before going to hospital.
Yeah, nothing's happening. Alright, breathe through it. Breathe through it. Alright, breathe through it. Come on. Breathe through it. Deep breath. Breathe through it. Breathe through it. Breathe through it.
Come on, then you help yourself. Oh, my poster's done. I don't know what to do. Help me.
Breathe through.
Do what your body
he tells you to do. What's he telling you to do?
I don't know what he's telling me to do.
Yourself out and stress yourself out. I mean it. I know.
Come on. Marie.
Hold mummy's hand. Hold mummy's hand.
I'm here. Now look. Right. Now.
Zihanna. Bye, that's Hannah. A lovely name.
Thank you.
Zihanna. Where is it sort of?
Mum made up.
Really? Yeah. Brilliant. Okay. Do your temperature, your pulse, and get your consent signed, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Fine. Okay. When you're asleep, the operation will take place.
Mm-hmm.
They will suction, use suction and evacuation mm-hmm. of the uterus, okay? Are we ready?
Yeah.
Can we come in?
Lovely.
Okay.
It's hard.
Yeah, it is. A lady's life is not an easy one, is it?
Yeah, that's fine.
Not always, anyway.
Uh-uh.
No, that's fine.
Last deep breath. Good job. You can hold my hand. Okay.
How do you
feel? I'm scared.
You're scared, yeah. You can cry if you want, you can have a few tears. It's only natural, you know? Because it's an emotional time, isn't it? So you're allowed to have a few tears. Does your family know you're here?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. Mm-hmm. Who in your family knows you're here?
Mum and my sister.
Oh, that's good. Your mum knows you're here.
Yeah.
Let's try and relax. Just concentrate on the breathing.
Nice deep breath. Good girl. Try good.
Doing just fine.
Going to sleep?
Can you leave them?
Off to sleep?
He said he would come in on the
knees. Keep going. Oh, this already hurts.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Sit. Breathe
it. Breathe
keep
it.
Going.
Keep going.
Breathe
keep going,
love.
Was
that you air in your lungs?
You can almost see most of his
head. Oh, well, you'll start pushing hard now, girl.
She is.
No, Daddy's not having a go. He said you will, though.
Okay.
He said you will.
That's good.
Come on, keep going.
Keep going, Marie. Don't be afraid of pain. Push.
Go on, push it, because the more you push, the more it'll come out. Go on.
That's a good girl.
Keep going. Go on, push. Come on. There's his shoulders. There's his arm. And there's his body. Woo! There he is.
Oh, what a size.
There he is. I need a boy.
Hello?
Hi, Sandy.
Go and see your mum.
He's got a cold like his mummy, has he?
No, it's just a bit snuggy. It's just the mucus, yeah? Which he'll sneeze and clear. There you go. One baby.
Fine.
Well done.
One little bubby.
I'm just going to sit you up, and then we're going to get you back to your bed, okay? You're in recovery, all right? It's all finished.
Oh, my gosh.
will for me.
Oh, really? Thank you, Jesus. get back to my normal life. Yeah. But fresh college. Ooh, can make a future for my next job.
One of Jordan's kidneys isn't working properly. You'll have to have regular checkups for the next few years.
Hello. Hold on. Someone for you. Hello? Hey, yeah. No, thanks. No. Right, then I'll see you in a little while. Bye.
Although he hasn't been in touch for weeks, Marie's boyfriend calls to say he's on his way to visit his day-old son.
He was ringing up to find out if I wanted McDonald's.
You should have said yes, because I could have had it then.
No, but I'm not hungry.
What are you going to say to him?
I don't know. Seriously, I don't know at the moment. Just really giving me his child, really, and just let him look at him, really.
Like he pees all over him.
Yeah.
That's just made Mummy so happy.
Looks like off colour. Yeah.
Hey, but at least you got a smile on your face when you said it, which is more than what Marie had.
Thank you, Mom.
She looked as if it was something disgusting.
But it bloody was. It was horrible.
That's nice.
If he's going to be a dad to the kid, he's got to be a full-time dad. Not one of these part-time ones. Don't want one of them.
Why?
Stop chicken at me.
Have another pizza.
Okay. Wake up. Jordan.
Thomas, can you
hear me? Hello, sweetie.
Hello. I had to get up 8 o'clock and feed your son.
So, it won't fall.
Your pizza's
just
come in.
Annoying.
Just saying,
I'm
not
the
doctor. Don't eat mum or cheeses.
No. Bloody kid. No, your daddy's a bloody kid.
And how many packs of Maltese have I bought you?
Half them off. I want a good one.
I can't wait to go back to college to feel normal again. Not myself. A young teenager. I feel so older. But this time I'm going to be finding more wives than other people when I go to college. I know what college boys are all about.
Marie's decided to give Joe another chance. Back home, she's visited by her midwife.
There's two issues here, isn't there? There's how he's dealing with you, but perhaps even more importantly to that is how he's dealing with this man.
Yeah,
no, he does. He wants
That's
to.
Really normal now. Yeah. That's because baby's nice and cute and little. And
yeah, that's what I was thinking. He's going to be all over him now.
But the test is when
he gets a bit older.
I like it. The biggest thing is that you make yourself happy and you get yourself some goals and work towards them, because I think baby learns about how to run his life from you.
Yeah.
And if he sees you dreaming about something and working towards something, then he's going to find something to work towards
as
well.
And he's
going
to do it himself.
Right.
Achieve more. I know I can achieve more, and so when I do have my child, they can look at me and say, you know, my mum's, you know, doing this and that, and I'll be able to give that child what it needs, and you know, so they could have something in life as well.
Next week's programme explores the complexities and taboos surrounding sex education. That's next Thursday at 9:30. I walk away from self-serving, undeserving.
gone.